Good morning, everyone. Last class, we discussed about racial groups of Indian society. In racial groups, we discussed about nearly 6 different racial groups of India. This is the second class, which we are going to discuss now about the origin of Indian civilization. In origin of Indian civilization, now we are going to talk about the Indus Valley civilization. So here it is believed that Indus Valley civilization was the joint creation of Aryans and non-Aryans. It is the joint creation of Aryans and non-Aryans. It is also associated with two cities, that is Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa. These are the main two cities which we could find in the Indus Valley civilization. And also there is evidence of the presence of different groups, racial groups, which influenced on the Indus Valley civilization. So before the civilization started, which we could find, many racial groups had come to Indian society. In that we could see Proto-Australoid, Mediterraneans, Alpine, as well as the Mongoloids. This group of people, these racial groups of people, they influenced on the civilization. We could find it was also an urban civilization. This Indus Valley civilization is a urban civilization, because we could find that mainly they made the urban plannings, which we could find in the cities. Here, especially in Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa, we could find the plannings which they made there. It was dependent on the cities, how do they plan. So we call that as an urban civilization. And also here we could find, because of the influence of all these things, even in the present society, we have some influence from the past. That is worship of Shiva and Lingam, which we can find. There is some traces of this which we are finding in the present society also, where the people worship Shiva and Lingam even in the present society. So Indo-Aryans are the later people who came to Indian society. Before them, we could find many other people had already come to the Indian society. Now here the process of Aryanization, how the Aryans influenced on the Indian society. So when the Indo-Aryans came to Indian society, the majority of the influence on the Indian society we could find. So they were pastoral people with a flair of poetry, philosophical speculation and elaborate rituals. They were interested in poetry as well as philosophical speculation and elaborate the rituals. They were mainly concentrating on this, as well as they regarded them as a superior ones. And they looked the people who are already, they had come to the Indian society, they saw them as the people who are the inferior ones. They looked them in the down. Then here they married within their own groups. So that we call it as an endogamous type of marriage, where the people get married within the groups. We call that as an endogamous type of marriage. This was followed by the Indo-Aryans. Then we could see they concentrated on the purity and pollution. The people who followed the rituals, and especially we can see that the Indo-Aryans, they themselves, they called them as a pure people. And the other inhabitants who came to Indian society, they called them as a impure ones. That is that where we could find the purity and pollution started in the society. From this, we could find the variation in this people here, we can see this led to the origin of Varna and Jati. So Varna, we could find that there are 4 different Varnas. So here we could see with this Varna system, Jati also started existing in the Indian society. The Indo-Aryans were divided into 3 groups, that is Rajanya, Brahmana and Vaishya. Rajanya, the people who are the warriors, then Brahmanas are the priests, Vaishyas are the cultivators. So these are the 3 groups which we could find from the Indo-Aryans. So these were called as a Dvija. Dvija means twice born. The person who will get the position here from the birth as well as after the birth, because of the rituals, beliefs, all these things. So because of those concepts, they were called as a Dvija. So here we could find the 4th Varna is Shudra. Shudras were the people who are the outside Indo-Aryan groups which were there. They were called as the Shudras. They were given the lowest position in the society. So they were occupying the different types of occupations, the lower occupations by the Shudras. So after that also we could find fifth group was also found in the society, that is called as Avarna or Panchama. So Avarna and Panchama groups, they are the people who are looked in a very lower position in the society, as well as we could find they had the very low occupations. So they were called as a Panchamas. Even the touching of this people, touching of the Panchamas used to pollute the higher class people, higher caste people. This was the concept in the society. Because of that we can see that these people, as well as the here we could see the Indo-Aryans, they looked the non-Aryans as the very low caste people or low Varna people in the society. After this we could find each Varna had its own jatis. So the Varnas which we could find here, so we have four different Varnas here: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. So all the Varnas, they had the different jatis which we could find. So many different types of jatis existed in the Indian society. With this, the new jatis also started existing in the society. So this we could find where we, from the Aryanization, because of the trends of the Aryanization, Indo-Aryans started discriminating on the Aryans. Non-Indo-Aryans who were there, they started discriminating on them. They looked them as a very lower people in the society. The major difficulties in the process of Aryanization. So in this we have three major difficulties which they faced. First one is tribal groups refused to be observed. So in this we could find that tribal groups, they refused to be observed here. They started living in the forest as well as the hills. So they did not take the any changes from the Indo-Aryans. So that was one of the major challenge for them. As well as we could find that they started keeping their own identities, and even presently also we could find that majority of the people who live in the forest as well as the hilly regions, we could find they maintain their own identities. So that was one of the challenges. Second one, special problems posed by strong ethnic groups. So in this, some of the groups here, the strong ethnic groups like Reddys in Andhra Pradesh, then Nayars in Kerala, as well as the Marathas in Maharashtra. These people economically and politically they were strong, but the position, the status which were given to them, here we could find they could not get the status of Shudra because economically and politically they are strong, as well as they could not give the higher status as a Dvija, because these people, they are not born, as well as formally it is not given to them. So that here we could find they started getting the status of next to the Kshatriyas. So that was one of the challenges to the Indo-Aryans. Next one is later waves of immigrants. The immigrants who came to Indian society, that is Greeks, Parthans, then Shakas, Kushans and Huns. The people who came to Indian society, these people, they started adopting the culture of the Indians. So the process of assimilation started, but the people, the native people who were there, they did not accept the immigrants who came to Indian society. They refused to give all the facilities for them. So because of that we could find there was a challenge for these people. So these are the three main difficulties which we could find for the Aryanization process. Development of Hindu religious philosophy. The Indian social system, here we could see it is believed to be the bound and rigid. Because here we could find that there are some exceptions also we could find in the Indian society, because some of the people who have written some of the epics, all these things, so Indian society have been changed. So epics like Valmiki's Ramayana and Vedavyasa's Mahabharata, this has been influenced on the Indian society. So because of that we could find some of the changes in the Indian society. Then some of the literary sources like Vedas, Upanishads, Dharma Sutras, then Rigveda is the oldest Veda in the Indian society. Then later on Samaveda, Yajurveda and Atharvana Veda was existed. So this literary sources also have been influenced on the Hinduism. So they have adopted some things, some of the literary things have been influenced there, and they have been taken that to the Hinduism also. Then epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, with that two main writings like Kautilya's Arthashastra and Manu's Manusmriti, this also have been influenced on the Hinduism. So here we could find all these literary works where it is influenced on the Hinduism. So the changes which we could see in the religious concepts there. Then the word Hindu was coined by invading Arabs. Because of the Indus word, they coined this word Hindu. Then here we could see Hinduism, it accepted the heterogeneity in the society, the changes which we had in the Indian society, because many people here, Indo-Aryans, which we can see, non-Indo-Aryans, then many more people who came to Indians. So because of them, we can see some of the rituals, beliefs, so all these things was accepted. The whole Hinduism, we can see there is lots of changes in the rituals from one group to another group, beliefs, with all these things we have the changes. Then after that we could find that Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, so all different religion, these three main religions, it also existed in the Indian society, and Buddhism especially, we can see it became a worldwide religion. So Jainism as well as the Sikhism we have in some parts of the Indian society, which they follow this particular religion. With this we can find the Hindu religious philosophy has been existed, the Hinduism, the changes which we could find in the Indian society. Christianity in India. Two main religions, Christianity as well as the Islam, which came to Indian society. So the first religion was Christianity, which came to Indian society. So the influence on the Indian society was more by the Christianity. So here we could see St. Thomas and Bartholomew, who came to Indian society, they influenced on the Indian society, and they were the first people who came to Indian society. They are the people. Then Portuguese, when the Portuguese arrived in India, so here we could see nearly seven kingdoms in Kerala, already it was the Christianity. Already the people was following the Christianity in seven kingdoms of Kerala. Then here Kalyan near Bombay, they made it as a major center for all the activities. The activities, whatever they conducted, so it, the Kalyan was the major center for that, where they all the activities was taken by that particular place. Then St. Francis Xavier, when he landed in Goa in 1542, it had become a Christian settlement already. So he could find the changes there already in the that particular place, that is Goa, where we can find. So he tried to make some changes in the that particular place. Then with that, Italian Jesuit Robert De Nobili, so he landed in Goa in 1605, and he died in Mylapore in 1656 in Madras. So he is the person who influenced on the Indian society. He is the Jesuit person. So Nobili, his main aim was to convert the people. So he started converting the people. So for that, his main technique was to use their own dialect. So he started speaking in Tamil. Then we could find that their own regional dialect he learned, and he started speaking to the people. Then with the Brahmins, he started speaking in Sanskrit. Then with that, we can see that he started influencing on the people, because he spoke in the same language which they could understand very easily. With that, here we can see his associates who were there, they started converting the people. So the major conversion in the Indian society took place by the Nobili, who came to Indian society. Then after that, later on, Dutch, British and French people who came to Indian society, they stayed for a long some time, but Britishers who came to Indian society, they stayed for a very long time. Till 1947 we could see that Britishers who stayed in the Indian society. French people was a very short time who stayed here, and their influences very short. Then after that, the humanitarian works which we can see, it was done by the Christian missionaries, where they helped the people in a different ways. So that the help which we are doing for the poor people, it was influenced on the poor people, and many people, they started converting to Christianity. That we could find. Then with that we could find in most of the states of Indian unions, we find the Christian people who are staying there. the population here, when we find here, especially in the north side, when we go here, some of the tribals have been converted to Christianity because of the Christian missionaries' influence, which we could find. Then in all the states, some percentage of Christianity is existed in the society. Islam in India. Islam, religion which came to Indian society, for the first time it came in a peaceful method. But after that, with the encouragement of some of the kings and the rulers, which we can see in the western coast, Bhalapur dynasty in the north and Zomerian in Malabar coast, who came to Indian society. So when they came to Indian society, here we can see they gave the place for them for the settlement as well as the to be here only and exist some of the to establish some of the mosques and do the all the religious activities. Then after that, Arab and Persian settlement, and these people, especially Arab and Persians who came to Indian society, they married non-Muslim women. When they married non-Muslim women, we call them as a Nawad in Konkan and Mapilla in Malabar. So these people are from the Arab and Persian settlement. Then with that, we can see after that, Ghazni, who came to Indian society, when he invaded the country, before him itself, we could see already many rulers, already Muslim invaders had come to the Indian society. Already the influence of Islam was there in the Indian society. Then this people, especially here, they wanted to make the Indian society as a Islamizing the society here. They thought of Islamizing the society, try to convert the people here in the Indian society. But many people, they did not accept that. They were not ready to give up their rituals, their beliefs, and go to the Islam. So with that, what they did, so here we could find for the discrimination purpose, where we can find they started collecting the tax. The different types of tax they started collecting. So that is called as jizya and kharaj. So these are the two different types of tax. So with this, here we can see the people who started ignoring them, where they did not accept the Muslim rules, as well as where they did not accept the accepting the Islamization. So there we could find they made the three options for them. These three options are to embrace Islam and accept the Muslim rule. One, they had to accept the Muslim rule. So whatever they are saying, whatever they are implementing, any rules if they implement, they had to accept that. That is the first one. Second option is to pay jizya or kharaj. They had to pay the tax. How much tax they are going to implement on the people, so depending on the situation, so that tax had to be paid by the people. And the third option is they had to fight against them. If they are ready, if they are very strong, so they should be ready to fight against the Islam rulers. So this was the condition which we can see. Then after some times, which we can see that the conflict between these two people started, but we could find slowly the assimilation process was going on between the Indian as well as the Islam rulers. So between these two, which we can see, the assimilation process was going on. And Islam started accepting some of the Indian things. Like for example, here we can see the Indianized, Islam also was Indianized because of some of the things that we could find in the art and architecture and medicine, some of the literary works. In these things we could find that. Then after that, this people especially, the Islam rulers, psychologically they were satisfied that because they are the rulers, which they got the kingdom, where we can see they are very strong now because they got the, psychologically they are strong because they got all the facilities. But economically and socially, they were weak. Because here they did not get any, where we can see these people, especially who were there in the Indian society, already they were economically very strong. These are the invaders who came from the other place. So here the people already who were there, economically and social background was very strong for them. And after some time we can see, slowly we could see the changes in the Islam as well as the Indian society because of this invaders who came. And after that we can see some changes where they started accepting some of the things in the Indian society, and even presently also we could find some percentage of people who live in the Indian society. Arrival of the Europeans. Portuguese, who entered in India in 1499, So when they entered Indian society, we could find some of the changes which they brought to the Indian society. Mainly they concentrated on the changes like cultural changes in the Indian society, but they did not think about the administration or some economically or something like that. Here we can see that when they came to Indian society, they thought about some of the cultural changes which they could bring in the Indian society. Then after that, Dutch, British and French who came to Indian society. But British stayed for a very long time. Till 1947, British stayed in Indian society. But French was very short time who stayed in the Indian society. The influence of the French was very little. Then Portuguese impact on religion, they impacted on religion, music, as well as the festivities. Especially we can see that they tried to shape the Goan culture. So even presently also the culture what the Goan people is having, it is mainly because of the influence of the Portuguese. Then French influence was limited. They had a very few days, which we can, very few short time they were in the Indian society. So because of that, we could find the influence was very little. But here we can see the British influence was more on the Indian society. Because British stayed till 1947, that is till we get the independence, British were there in the Indian society. So they complicated their people. If they had any problems in the Indian society, to appreciate their people, they complicated them in a different ways. So here we can see that they had a common system of administration, penal code, as well as the civil procedure code. They brought this to the society. Then we can see legally whatever changes they brought to the society. Then we could see they brought the English education to the society. So because of the English education which they brought to the society, many people from the Indian society, they got education. Formal education was there in the society. Many Christian missionaries, they established the schools. And with this influence, some of the people from India, they got some influence and they got the education, English education. Because of the influence of the English education, which we can see, these educated people, they created the Indian Renaissance. They created the changes in the Indian society, where we could see they could understand the misuse of the people, the Britishers, how they used to misuse the people and how they used to administrated the society. So the people was not happy, the people were educated. So what they did, they started launching the movement, where the independent movement was launched by these people. So they initiated and they launched the people. With that, we can see that the independent movement started in the Indian society. With all these things which we can see, Indian people, they try to concentrate on the self-image, as well as we can see they try to keep their culture in the society. So with this, we can see that the changes, as well as after a very long fight between the Britishers as well as the Indian people, we could find that we got the independence. But after that, we can see that the changes in the Indian society, when we start from the first civilization, that is Indus Valley civilization, till the modern era, we can see many invaders have come to the Indian society, as well as we could find there are many racial groups, as well as many literary works, which we can see all these things have been influenced on the Indian society. And with this, we could find the changes in the Indian society. This diversities which we have in the Indian society, it may be religious, linguistic, cultural, caste, all these diversities we have in the Indian society. In spite of having all these things, still the people from the past, present and future, they stay together, and we could find the where we can see they have a unity among them. That is what we have in the present society also. Thank you. Let us meet in the next class.